Dear friend, welcome to the lecture series in electromagnetic fields and waves. In today's video lecture, we are going to derive the expressions for the Lorentz force equation, which is the concept derived from the force on a moving charge. And also, we are going to solve certain numerical problems based on the formula that we have derived. Coming to the topic, according to Coulomb's law, a stationary or moving charge Q experiences an electric force Fe bar. And the Fe bar can be written as Fe bar equals to QE bar. Let us consider this one as equation one. Suppose when the charge is placed in a steady magnetic field, it experiences a force only when the charge is in motion. The magnetic force Fm bar exerted on the charge Q moving with velocity U bar in a magnetic field of flux density B bar is Fm bar equals to QU bar cross B bar. Let us consider this one as equation two. Using cross product definition, the magnitude of Fm bar can be written as Fm equals to QUB sine theta. For a positive charge, the direction of force, Fm bar is in the direction of the cross product U bar cross B bar, and it is perpendicular to the plane containing U bar and B bar according to the right hand rule. And this is shown in the given figure. If a moving charge Q is in the presence of both the electric and magnetic fields, then the electromagnetic force acting on the charge is given by F bar equals to summation of Fe bar plus Fm bar. Now, substituting the equations 1 and 2 in the above equation, we get F bar equals to QE bar plus QU bar cross B bar. Now, taking Q as common, then we get F bar equals to Q of E bar plus U bar cross B bar. Now, this equation is known as the Lorentz force equation. The Lorentz force equation relates the mechanical force to the electric force. If M is the mass of the charged particle moving with velocity in both E bar and B bar fields, then by Newton's second law of motion, we can write F bar equals to MA, where A is the acceleration, and it can be written as the rate of change of velocity. So we can write that one as du bar over dt. So therefore, relating the mechanical force to the electrical force, F bar equals to m du bar over dt equals to Q of E bar plus U bar cross B bar. Let us summarize. Looking at the state of the particle, when the particle or the charge is at stationary position, in presence of the electric field, the force exerted on the Q is Fe bar equals to QE bar. And when the charge is in stationary position, in presence of the magnetic field, the force exerted on the charge is nothing. And in presence of both the electric field and magnetic field, the force exerted on the charge is due to only the electric field, so that the electric force can be written here as F bar equals to QE bar. When the charge is in motion, in presence of electric field, the force exerted on the moving charge is Fe bar equals to QE bar. And in presence of the magnetic field, the force exerted on the moving charge Q is Fm bar equals to QU bar cross B bar. And in presence of both electric field and magnetic field, the force exerted on the moving charge is F bar equals to Q of E bar plus U bar cross B bar. And we call this one as the Lorentz force equation. And also, let us see certain things related to the force on a moving charge in case of electric field as well as the magnetic field. The electric force is always in the direction of the electric field, whereas the magnetic force is always perpendicular to the magnetic field. The electric force acts on a stationary or a moving charge, whereas the magnetic force acts on it when the charge is in motion. The electric force displaces a point charge at the cost of the energy, whereas no work is done by the magnetic force when the charge is displaced. Let us look at a numerical problem. The problem one says, find the force on a particle of mass 1.7 into 10 power minus 27 kg and charge 1.602 into 10 power minus 19 coulomb if it enters a field of magnetic flux density B equals to 10 milli Weber per meter square with an initial velocity of 90 kilometer per second. Let us go to the solution. Write the given data. The given data contains the magnetic flux density B, which is 10 milliWeber per meter square, and Q equals to 1.602 into 10 power minus 19 coulombs, and the velocity U is 90 km per second. And here, assuming that B bar and U bar are perpendicular to each other, to be found is the magnetic force experienced by the moving charge Q. The formula to be used is Fm equals to QUB. So here already we assume that B bar and U bar are perpendicular to each other. So we get BU sine theta, and theta is 90 degrees. Then we get 1, and the formula is Fm equals to QUB. Coming to the calculation, take the formula and try to substitute the values of Q, U, B. Then we get Fm equal to 14.42 into 10 power minus 17 newtons. Finally, writing the result, the force on the given particle is 14.42 into 10 power minus 17 newtons. Coming to the another numerical problem, and it says a point charge of 4 coulomb moves with a velocity of 5 ax bar plus 6 ay bar minus 7 az bar meter per second. Find the force exerted if the magnetic flux density is 5 ax bar plus 7 ay bar plus 9 az bar Weber per meter square. Go to the solution, write the given data. The given data contains Q equal to 4 coulombs, U bar equals to 5 ax bar plus 6 ay bar minus 7 az bar meter per second, and B bar equals to 5 ax bar plus 7 ay bar plus 9 az bar Weber per meter square. To be found is the force exerted on a moving charge in presence of magnetic field, that is Fm bar is equal to how much we need to find. The formula to be used is Fm bar equals to QU bar cross B bar. Go to the calculation. Let us take the formula and let us find what is U bar cross B bar first. So U bar cross B bar we can write in determinant form, and the first row takes the unit vectors, and the second row takes the values of the U bar, and the third row takes the values of B bar, and these values are nothing but the coefficients. Finally, finding the U bar cross B bar, and we get U bar cross B bar equals to 103 ax bar minus 80 ay bar plus 5 az bar. Now calculating the Fm bar, which is equivalent to Q U bar cross B bar, then we have the Q value as 4. Then when we multiply the U bar cross B bar with the constant 4, then we get Fm bar equals to 412 ax bar minus 320 ay bar plus 20 az bar newtons. Then we can also find the magnitude of the force Fm bar by taking the square root of summation of square of all the individual terms related to ax bar, ay bar, az bar as square root of 412 square plus minus 320 square plus 20 square. Then we get Fm equals to 522.05 newtons. Finally, writing the result, the force exerted on the moving charge is Fm equals to 522.05 newtons. Hope you like this video. Please do subscribe my channel and click the bell icon so that you will be notified with the latest videos in the series of electromagnetic fields and waves. Thanks for watching.